Oh, Latin, it is a dead language, as dead as dead can be. First it killed the Romans, and now it's killing me. There I was, brothers, barely 12 years old, a nervous new boy at the Mark Cross Junior Seminary. Ahead lay years of priestly training, and Latin, lots of Latin. Amo, amatus, 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 amatus. Brothers, I wasn't the sharpest knife in the drawer. There were smart lads there, brothers, lads just like all of you. They weren't doing Latin, they were doing Latin and Greek. But still I put my shoulder to the wheel. Dominus, domine, domino, domine, domino, domino. So many E's and A's and O's, singers and plurals, numbers and accusatives. It was all I could do to keep my genitives from getting caught in my relatives. Next chapter by chapter, I valiantly fought my way through Gaul, shoulder to shoulder with those legendary leaders of men, Julius Caesar and Christmas Bonus. But it was the poet Virgil and his epic tale of the fall of Troy, which finally brought my chariot wheels to a shuddering halt in the clogging sands of incomprehension. Clogged, bogged down, utterly baffled, with the walls of Troy crashing and burning on all sides, and our hero Aeneas fleeing to escape the blazing city and the spears of the Grecian invader. Brothers, I was not far behind him. You see before you, brothers, the yet proud owner of a Latin O-level, Great C. Should Latin be taught in schools, brothers, it was character building. It taught us perseverance, determination, and that noble virtue writ large upon the heart of every South and Catenian brother, cheerfulness in the face of adversity. But as for linguistic relevance, there I can be of little help. Latin, it was all Greek to me. Yeah.